So in this lecture, we are talking about adaptive FIR filters. Is T missing? Adaptive FIR filters. So this means that in our FIR filters, the coefficients can change. So remember, our FIR filter was something like that we have here multiplied by this coefficient and then multiplied by this coefficient and multiplied by this coefficient, and then we have an output here. So that's our input x of n. That's our output y of n. And so these coefficients here, they can now change. Yeah, so these are now able to change. And so now the question is obviously, how do we change these coefficients, and so why would we do it? Yeah, so we need to address this how to change, and then obviously also, so why would we change coefficients? Yeah, so that's obviously not directly clear why we would do that anyway. And so let's just find a motivation for this here. So let's just continue with adaptive filter, and let's introduce an error signal. So let's just introduce an error signal E of n, which is an error signal between a desired state and y of n, which is the output. So we have a desired filter output and here we have the actual output, the actual filter. And then we are defining an error signal here. And so what we're doing is with the error signal is here, with the error signal, with this error signal, we tune the FIR filter and change the coefficients here. So with that, so use that to change H of the FIR filter. So we can draw this as a simplified version of this. So adaptive filter. So let's just draw the FIR filter just here as a box, and it gets this x of n, and then the output is y of n. And so now what we're doing is here. So the remember the definition what I had here is E equals to is d minus y. So our error signal. So we have here our d of n, and this over y of n. And so, and this is your negative, and this is your positive. And then this is here changing the coefficients here of the filter. So this means here. Changes the coefficients. Coefficients h. And so we have here a negative feedback loop. So we like that here. So that's a negative feedback loop. And so the error signal E here, E of n, then will be changed in the way that at some point it will be zero, and that the error signal manipulates the FRR filter in the way that y is changing, and then eventually the difference between d and y becomes zero, and then the error signal converges here. And this approach is also called the least mean square filter approach. So why is that square? Because at the end we minimize e of n square. Yeah, so because it doesn't matter if it's positive or negative. And so therefore that's the reason why it's called least mean square.